What's up, everybody, and welcome to another episode of The Supreme Decisions. And today I actually want to continue a little bit more with going deeper into hearsay. But in this portion, I want to talk about the gathering of evidence. Now, one of the books that I actually stumbled upon while I was actually getting ready for my racketeering case was The Fundamentals of Criminal Investigation. And it's by Charles E. O'Hare and Gregory L. O'Hara. Now, in this book, it goes through step by step, and it also goes through one of the greatest fundamentals of two questions that need to be asked at the beginning of every investigation. And for me, it was chapter 27, and it's questions to ask yourself when formulating your matter for defense, because it's the reason why I speak about going into map hearings, going into weight hearings, going into these other evidentiary hearings. The first question that needs to be asked is, has the officer taken precaution to obtain the evidence that is admissible? Because a lot of times when you're looking about that, I've shown a video or several videos where it speaks about, did they get a warrant prior to doing a search? Were they able to point to a particular area? Even if they were giving a call, was the caller actually calling about an actual crime or just mere suspicion? And these things go into account because these things are the things that formulate or set up probable cause. The second question, has the officer observed the rules which govern admissibility? And see, in this world, you go into the warrant application. You look at the chain of custody. You also look at, in some matters, how was something tested. There are other things that you need to go, but those are the questions that need to be answered in each and every criminal investigation. Because, again, all of that is a part of hearsay or being a part of things that are admissible against you or at trial. And even in a matter in which you're doing a case against someone, these things you also have to take into account, because you are now the one that has to have obtained the evidence in a timely manner, in a admissible manner. So keep that in mind. Are you following the rules that govern admissibility? Have they followed the rules that govern admissibility? Did you take precaution in gathering evidence? Has the officer taken precaution in gathering evidence? These things are the crux of any prosecution or any defense. So keep that in mind. And like I say, let's keep going. Apple Pay, Venmo, Cash App. And if you don't have it right now, hit my link in the description. We both get paid. And Google Wallet. I appreciate you guys. And until next time.